Treasury market spinning its tires here as we waited for the Fed minutes to come in and save the day. And lo and behold, things didn't really look all that different than they did this morning before the Fed minutes. We saw yields trading lower, still holding below that 2.75 mark. It's been doing that for now, you know, 6-7 straight sessions. We haven't been back above 2.75. That was the old line in the sand. So as we say in yield speak, it's the new resistance. You start to see yields creep up. They're having difficulty getting to 2.75. They got close today, but we're unable to get through it again. So the market just still remains in a bullish sort of holding pattern. Yield speak, and to me it just feels like we had an auction today that went well. We had a three-year auction yesterday that didn't go so well, but the market seems to be absorbing the supply and the demand is there despite the fact that yields are lower. And if we look at market volatility, we did see market volatility start to turn today after those minutes with the idea that, well, now we know what the Fed might be thinking and the market starts creeping back higher towards the old range. We didn't get back into the old range, which would have been a real volatility blow. But we saw basically volatility is still elevated, but just now on the low end of that elevated scale. And what that suggests to me is that the market fear is gone. And now it's kind of waiting for some information, whether it be from the Fed, whether it be from the data, whether it come from Washington and this mess and the shutdown. So I think that there's a couple of different variables to look at here. But volatility is telling you that while the market is still concerned, it's not scared. When you start to see volatility spiking higher and you see bond buyers come in and it moves us way out of the range and, you know, 1 or 2 days in a row, things start to look a little ugly. They don't look like that anymore. And lastly, let's look at those minutes and some Fed speakers today. The minutes came out obviously much more dovish than expected. The Fed obviously more concerned about growth, more concerned about the financial markets and the financial institutions. And they are looking at caution at possibly, we'll call it, taking a pausing for a while, waiting to see what happens with the data, waiting to see what goes on before predicting their next rate hike. And the market already told you that, but still it's different when it's coming from the Fed. And earlier before the Fed minutes, we had three Fed speakers. We had Bostic, Rosengren, and Evans, all of whom were very dovish, talking about the concerns of raising rates too fast and likely being on hold for some time, maybe first quarter, I think is implied, but maybe that maybe could be a little bit longer. But the market definitely now feeling that the Fed is going to be trying to talk down any kind of fear that rates are going to scare the market or going to slow the economy down at a point in time when it really doesn't need to be slowed down. If you look at the GDP numbers, they are holding well below 3%, and that's not something that the Fed, or at least is used to over the last several quarters. So right now, the Fed being very cautious, Treasuries remaining in bullish mode, and volatility coming off a little bit suggests that we might be in for more of the same of this. Let's not forget, we do have a government shutdown still ongoing. We have Brexit on the brain, which I know it isn't until March 29th, but we were saying just a few months ago, yeah, it's March 29th. It'll be here before we know it. And until they get a resolution, that is going to continue to keep all financial instruments volatility at least better bid than it had been. And Treasury yields will remain low as long as there's a little bit of fear and a flight to quality.